Parish President Randy Dillat is back in his old stomping grounds, French Settlement. Big celebration going on for the new police station. Therein hangs a tale. Of course, you just took office. You sort of inherited this. But what a great day down here.
It's a great day for nothing else but the weather, Ken. The weather is beautiful. The community's a tight, small community. They all came out to support the great job that Speaker Clay Schneider has did in securing these funds. It's a beautiful building. Looking forward to the leadership of French Settlement in the future.
So it goes to show you that if you're going to build stuff down here, you have to get grants to do it.
And that's why the legislation, legislators are so important. We have freshman legislators. In the past, we was fortunate to have people that was very well experienced. And how much more experience can you get than to be the Speaker of the House?
Well, the session's about to start, and I'm sure you're very concerned about drainage. And down here, that has to be the top priority.
Top priority is drainage, and we do have some infrastructure issues, but the drainage is the top priority. It just seems like government red tape is always in the way, and that's the biggest battle to try to fight the red tape to get some of this drainage done.
Well, fortunately, you inherited several projects that are ongoing, so there'll be a lot more drainage work coming, right?
There's one project ongoing now. It's a de-snagging. It's just about completed. It's probably got about two more months in it, yes.
And that's the Amead River?
That's the old river, Pity Amead, and all those projects. The Amead River did not get authorized. There was a $25 million that was to take out the high spots from Port Vincent to EBR, and that didn't, because of LMI, low to moderate income, it didn't qualify.
Well, that's a shame. I'm sure the efforts will continue.
Those efforts are going to continue. We're going to try to concentrate more on the lower end than above us. And hopefully we have areas that we're qualified.
So drainage is getting better.
Drainage is getting better, but if you listen to all the scientists and all the people, they professors, they claim the sea level is getting higher and higher, and drainage is just part of the issue. We don't believe that, but we're going to have to do what we have to do.
Well, Greg Graves just announced some more money coming for the Comead River diversion, and that's going to help some in Livingston Parish.
That would help some, but I would love to see more money spent on the diversion project to the Bayou Manchac to Mississippi River. Another project would be great would be all the abandoned gravel pits in Watson area. You can make retention ponds out of that and let the water come slower to us. The issue is that every drop of water falls in our parish. We drain, but we also have to drain everything from East Baton Rouge that falls on the Mississippi River levee. So it all rolls through our parish. Most of our drainage is from the state of Louisiana and not Livingston Parish.
That's incredible. You can be standing next to the Mississippi River and a drop of rain that falls there is going to go to the Amead River.
Because we have no way of getting it to the Mississippi River. That's why we think the project of Bayou Manchac with pumps would help us do that. If you can make the water go a different route than drain down the Amead River, that's a win-win for us because we have so much trouble in getting the core to allow us to dredge.
Well, I hear you're coming up with an event for your first 100 days in office. Could it be that long?
No, I think we're about 45 or 46 days in office now. We have a lot of different things that we want to do. We want to meet in town hall meetings, and we're going to start those in the next 10 to 15 days. We have been doing all the other meetings where the homeowners associations, we've been meeting in Washington, D.C., we've been meeting in Lafayette, Baton Rouge, Houma. We met everywhere. We're leaving no stone unturned. We're just searching for money.
But you'll have a little event or something to celebrate your 100 days in office?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, we will. It's still in the works. I think you probably know more about it than I do. I think they reached out to y'all to cover it, but I know we are going to have an event.
Deer Run is back on the agenda, the big controversial subdivision.
Be honest, I hadn't looked at the agenda, but Deer Run currently has a stop work order on it. I had read an article in a paper where they said they had received a construction permit. That's not true. And so until they go through all the first meeting I attended after being elected as parish president, I was given authority by the council to make sure all the I's were dotted and all the T's was crossed. Currently, they do not have a construction work permit, and that's why the stop work order's there. I'm assuming they're going to come and try to get that.
Well, do you think it can be stopped through the legal process? After all, they would say that they did all the paperwork.
If they did all the paperwork, then it shouldn't be stopped. No, sir.
So it's somewhat undecided?
In my mind, in the administration's mind, it is undecided that they followed all the rules.
So you're looking for a way to stop it, because let's be honest, most people just want to stop the development. Wouldn't you agree?
No, not necessary. I think it's possible it can be a development. I don't think you can have 8 townhomes on an acre, but I think it's possible to have a development there. The bottom line is, regardless of what they're going to try to have, you have to go through the process. You can't take shortcuts, and that's what happened here.
Well, you're working on a lot. What else do you want to share with us?
I just want to thank the people for giving me this opportunity. I've been doing this job for 7 days a week, 18 hours a day, and I can tell you I can't be more happier. I have a lot of support from a lot of elected officials. I have a lot of support from my community. I also know this is a honeymoon period. I also know that I have to get as much accomplished in my first year as I can while I have a great team around me, and I currently have that.
Jeremy Idell is the mayor pro tem here in French Settlement, where it's fair to say today is a red letter day with the dedication of the new police station, obviously from a grant, but boy, you'll take it.
Absolutely. We want to thank our government officials for securing the funding for us to get this beautiful new police department built. For years and years, and we've been at an underutilized building. We hadn't had anywhere for our police officers to change, to take a shower, and this new facility is going to allow them to do all that, and it looks quite impressive as well. So
you have to wonder how many years it'll be before towns the size of French Settlement just can't afford a police department of their own anymore.
Well, yes, that is a good assessment, but I've got some ideas going forward on ways to increase revenue so we can be more self-sustaining. Live within our means and quit actually dependent upon the state government for money, because it's all about if you can attract good business to the area, you know, bring in some good revenue, then you could be self-sustaining in that regard.
Does anybody ever bring up the speed trap option? If you look at the amount of money a town could make, it must be tempting.
We're not a speed trap town at all. There obviously laws and stuff against that, and quite frankly, with a town of our size compared to some of our local municipalities, we bring in much less than your typical speed trap town. So we could pull over everyone, but we don't want to do that. We want to bring in revenue, you know, occupational taxes from our businesses and what have you. So
with the popularity of Swamp People and all those other TV shows, and the guys who do that, they live around here every weekend. Everybody descends on the rivers, the Amead River, the Diversion Canal, the Tickfaw River. Yeah. Isn't tourism a viable option for you?
I'm sure glad you brought that up, because we're trying to really promote tourism here in Livingston Parish. We've rebranded. I know Eric's done a good job with that. And look, before long, you're going to see people looking at French Settlement as the tourism capital of Livingston Parish. And as long as I'm here, we're going to make that happen.
We already have a museum, don't you?
Absolutely. It's right here on the same grounds. We want to, you know, revisit the Creole Festival. The Creole Festival used to be a big event here. We want to get more parking so we can attract more people. You hit the head on the nail there with the tourism aspect. We can be the tourism place for Livingston Parish.
People are dying from the other parts of the country to experience what they perceive to be, thanks to television, the swamp life. And we live it every day and take it for granted.
Absolutely. Look, I was born and raised here in French Settlement. I've moved around. I've lived a lot of different places. But I came back home here because of that type of life. And it's unique. It's peaceful. We take that for granted sometimes.
There are millions of guys, if you could tell them, look, we'll go to a bar that you can only reach by water, and you see the local boys wrestling alligators just for fun, you would get a million tourists here.
Well, I don't know about wrestling alligators, but definitely, ballrooms by water. But look, all I'm going to say is French Settlement is an up-and-coming place. We've got our act together. And you're going to see a lot from this community going forward.
What else do you want to share with us?
I just want to say y'all do a good job. I watch your coverage across the parish, across Tangi Parish. Give you a plug, man. Y'all do good work, and thank y'all.
serving Livingston Parish and South Louisiana for over 85 years. The Bill Hood family of dealerships is growing. We've added two new stores. Come see us today at any of our eight locations. Bill Hood Ford Lincoln in Hammond. Bill Hood Nissan, Mazda, and Hyundai on the import corner in Hammond. Bill Hood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Amite. Bill Hood Chevrolet in Covington. And now, the new Bill Hood Premium Pre-Owned in Hammond and Bill Hood Pre-Owned Outlet in Ponchatoula. Click hoodauto.com.
What a great day it is in French Settlement. It's not every day that a big new thing is, well, inaugurated, such as the new police station, and therein hangs a tale. Assistant DA Brad Cassio is the town attorney. And you know, when it comes to a big thing in French Settlement, it doesn't get any bigger than this.
No, you're right. It definitely doesn't. It's very exciting. They desperately needed a new facility here for their police department. You know, it feels so much more professional, so much more welcoming now whenever you walk up to a beautiful building like this. And, you know, I know everybody down here is thankful for the help from Jeff Wiley and Clay Schicksnyder in helping make this happen.
So basically it came from grants?
That's my understanding, yes.
Well, you know, I wonder at these little police departments how long it'll be that towns the size of French Settlement will even be able to operate a local police department.
It does make it hard. You know, funding is definitely a challenge. I do think, though, this community is growing, and I think that's going to help.
And they are strapped. I mean, French Settlement has had some budget woes.
Oh, absolutely. Over the years, they definitely have. I mean, you know, there's only so many people here. There's only so many businesses and so many sources of revenue. But I do think that this administration down here right now is making the best of it, and they're doing a very good job of what they're given.
So there's a little inside story that you actually helped get a well-needed table for this facility.
Yes, Ken, that's correct. I was down here working the court one evening, and Chief Mosby gave me a tour of the court of the police station before it was finished, and he told me that one day when they have the extra money, they're going to buy a conference room table. And so I went out looking, and I found a man from the Dim Springs area that had an extra one that he was selling. I went and picked it up for the village, and I had to transport it down here just a couple days ago in time for the ribbon cutting. I feel like these small towns, like we said, they are serious budget constraints for them. And in a time like today where we need more people that are pro-law enforcement, anything I can do to help law enforcement, I'm happy to do. Good job of what they're given.
Tell us about this municipality. You're the town attorney, so you, I guess, conduct mayor's court, and you get to hear all the stories from local residents. Maybe they had a dispute over, I don't know, livestock or something. I've heard that in Roseland and other little towns.
So I represent I'm the prosecutor for the town, not necessarily the town attorney. So it used to be, I guess years ago, it was a mayor's court, but we actually have a magistrate, and I'm the prosecutor here. Been doing this in this village about 2 or 3 years now. And you're right, it is some interesting stories sometimes. You know, small town stories are often the best stories.
Why do we need, or what function is served by these little municipalities like French Settlement here and Port Vincent and all the rest?
Well, I think historically it gives people a sense of belonging more than anything else, really. You know, it's good to have these communities scattered throughout the parish and other areas, so people feel like they have a home and they have some local say-so and input on what goes on in their own community.
And, you know, I think with the popularity of Swamp People and other television shows based on Louisiana that are all set around here, the day is coming, mark my words, that this whole area between Gonzales and Ponchatoula is going to be a tourist draw. Watch what I'm telling you.
You might be right. You know, you're right. For a while there, I think we were Hollywood South, right, in this area. They were filming more and more projects down here, and I do think that's opened up a lot of tourism.
Because driving here down the long and winding roads, you just get a sense that in the whole world there's not another place like Lower Livingston. And it's the real thing. It's not a Hollywood set. It's not a recreation. It's still the genuine deal.
Oh, it's definitely authentic, you know, and it's not what you see on TV and in the movies. You're right, this is the real deal down here.
What else are you working on?
Well, I'm still an assistant DA for Scott Perilou. I've been there about 11 years now, prosecuting felonies. Mr. Perilou has me handling cases in all three parishes at the moment. Of course, I'm doing the parish government work as well in all three parishes, which keeps me very busy.
Well, Livingston's going to be a real challenge there, don't you think?
The Deer Run development that's been a thorn in the community side for quite some time now is back on the agenda.
So the smart money is that, I mean, all this leads to lawsuits. The fact that there are these permitted, but then on the other hand, it's sort of like the parish appeared to be an Indian giver going back on what they said, and it's a mess, really, because now you have a second administration with a different viewpoint.
Right. This administration does view it differently, and, you know, I have to say, I believe the community, I understand what they're saying, that it's too big of a development for this area. It's too many houses. It just doesn't function. And I agree with that. I don't think it's what's best for this community. But sometimes that differs in a court of law of what you actually have to prove and what you believe.
Well, Representative Jeff Wiley is on hand here in French Settlement, where they just cut the ribbon on the new police station. Admittedly, you didn't have much to do with it. Your predecessor, Clay Schecksnyder, who's actually a native of French Settlement, he got the job done. But, you know, it's a team effort and life goes on.
Well, Ken, I don't know. I mean, like, I've taken office 2 months ago and we already got a new police station in French Settlement. I mean, coincidence? Yeah. Yeah, obviously, the legislative delegation and the local leaders, and Clay in particular, my predecessor, made that happen. It's great to be here for that, yes.
Well, we see you out here on a Sunday afternoon, and isn't that what it's all about, being a representative for Lower Livingston, is that you'll be available, you'll be on hand, you won't be remote off in Gonzales or Baton Rouge or someplace?
Well, it sounds self-serving, and I don't know, this is sincere. I don't know how many places besides in Lower Livingston that you can go to a remodeled, refurbished, brand new police station and be by pastures, be by, we got music, we've got a pavilion here, all in the grounds of the town of French Settlement. That's really, to me, captures the character of Lower Livingston and what I want to be a part of.
Everything here becomes a party. No matter what it was scheduled to be, it becomes a party.
Yes, sir.
So the legislature just finished their crime session. You're the former sheriff of Ascension. What do you think?
Well, almost all of it I supported, and the governor's agenda is very similar to my agenda, which was quite frankly taking some of the reform, quote unquote, that was created and instilled 5 or 6 years ago. Most of it didn't work, Ken, and so in my opinion, but also statistically. So we went in there and changed a lot of the things, and some of it, you know, the death penalty issue, you know, the 17-year-old, which everybody got so nervous about it. 5 years ago, 17-year-olds were already adults. We tried it. It didn't work. The 17-year-old is at benchmark age where these kids are graduate to real serious crimes. I don't know if you know this, and I'll be brief. The parole, tweaking some of the parole issue, people were eligible parole, Ken, after 35% of their sentence. You get 10 years, you were doing three and a half years of a 10-year sentence, all right? We just thought that was a little too, let's just say, soft. So, yes, I was a part of that and proud to have been a part of that movement. Yes, sir.
A lot of sheriffs, they're concerned about prisoners. I mean, they don't have room in their jails now. They're getting a lot of DOC prisoners from the state. Don't we need to build more jails if we're going to go in this direction?
Well, if I don't know, that's it. It's each respective county parish figuring that out, and parish prisons and state prison. What we definitely need is more juvenile housing, positively. And you can call it detention centers, you can call it jails for young kids, or you can call it homes, okay? But secure facility. Our juvenile crime is off the scale. And we have a new type of crime, a new type of criminal, and they're 14, 15, 16, 17 years old, and they are not shoplifting, and they're not breaking into cars. They are shooting, killing, robbing, and carjacking. Yes.
Well, in the meantime, another session's about to start, and what bills can we look for from you?
Well, I have one that I'm still working on. It is a bail reform bill, to where one of the things that happens, people are upset about repeat crimes and violent crime, things like that. What I'm upset about, and I think most people are, is how did that guy not stay in jail? How is a guy that makes bond on a serious crime, and 3 weeks later you're reading about another serious crime that he committed? So I want to make it a little bit harder for those judges, or equip them with enough information to make sure they're making the right bail set for those people. There's other administrative stuff that I'm going to do. Matter of fact, I'm going to help here with a bill that's already there to get amended for the chief of police here, all right, to be required to come from the town confines, or the village confines, as it will, of French Settlement. So there's, you know, we got a lot of important stuff, insurance and tort reform and things like that, but it's also, what do you call it, housekeeping stuff like that. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Insurance will be huge. Tort reform is going to be huge. Wait and see. Yes.
Looks like the desnagging of the Amead River has hit, pardon the pun, a snag.
Yeah. You got to, yes, and this is a funding issue, and you got that Amite River Basin Commission, of which I made many meetings, and the sense of it, Ken, was, as you know, to stack the board. This is a reformulated with seven parish presidents to have each respective representative parish have clear and distinct representation. And you have seven others that are subject matter representatives. Well, like anything, maybe like the legislature too, you have differences of opinion and you have parochial issues and things like that. I, for one, would like to see them move a little bit quicker on a lot of their issues and a lot of their projects. That's that Watershed Initiative, WSI. $1.5 billion, maybe. And our region got the lion's share of it, which includes Ascension, Livingston, etc. And I know they have grand plans. I'd like to see grand projects. Grand bulldozers and grand shovels. Yes.
What else do you want to share with us?
Oh, life is good, and I'm here today. This is my first as an elected state official or state representative function, and literally my first speech. Short and sweet, by the way. I'm learning. Yeah.
We're back on the beautiful southeastern campus, actually underneath these oaks. This is probably the most beautiful part of that campus. Nobody knows that any better than Jeff Taylor, the Livingston assessor, who's not over here because of the scenery, but because the assessors from all over Louisiana are meeting right here. Boy, therein hangs a tale.
That's right. They're meeting here. Jeff Gardner, our president from Feliciana, he wanted to put something here because he went to school here. I went to school here. And so we were like, let's do something out there in Southeast. And he's done a great job. The conference, the union over here has been really, really good. And I can tell you now, this cool breeze blowing right now, if you put me a hammock out here, I'd be taking me a little nap for a while.
By the way, in the background, you hear the construction, and that is on the other part of the campus where the Humanities Building used to be. And boy, it's a construction site now.
Well, you know, Ken, I graduated 37 years ago from Southeastern. And when I got here, you could walk side to side in the campus and everything. And if you had a class in Whitehall and you had one in Humanities, man, you were just worried to death that you'd ever make it back. And now I look at it, it's not a large campus, but it's a very welcoming campus. And you can get around everywhere you want to get around this campus. And it's very convenient. And I really like the layout of it. And I like the things that they're doing here. The union is it's older, but it's way newer than when I was here. And so it's a nice campus, and people, you look at the kids and everything walking around here, it's nice.
Well, in particular, where you assessors are having your confab, you're only using a small portion of the building. So in other words, you could have a much larger gathering at the union.
No question. We're on the third floor, and it gives us plenty of room. We've got the tables and everything are laid out. It's got plenty of room, but we could also have access to the second floor. We could have access to other things around this campus that we didn't utilize because we're a smaller group. We could have used Strawberry Stadium. All of those things could have happened, but we just a small group.
So Hammond will never get a convention center because in order for it to work economically, we're told there has to be a casino attached to it. Okay, dead issue, done with that. But Southeastern is such an excellent second string.
Well, absolutely. Well, Baton Rouge right now is trying to come up with an idea of Pete Maverick, but they don't want it to compete with the city and everything. Well, Hammond's got some things here. We've got the Southeastern Union that is an absolutely fine facility. If you want a banquet or you want to host a conference or something like that, you need to come out here and look at it because you will be pleasantly surprised. The safety of it, you can walk around anywhere on this campus that you want to. You never feel threatened. There's no crime. And we're just enjoying the heck out of it. And I love the fact that I am a SLU graduate. It's cool.
So in the meantime, what are you guys talking about at the conference?
Well, we do all of our business this time of year. We meet four times a year on a regular basis, and then you have your annual conference. And so we're talking about anything with legislation, ITEPs, we're talking about watercraft, we're talking about millages, we're talking about all of those things that we need to follow. Anything that has to do with taxing or taxing districts or anything like that, we have to stay involved with that. And so that's what we do on a regular basis. So yesterday we had our legislative meeting. Yesterday we had our watercraft meeting. We had our General Assembly. Right now they're doing a memorial. We lost a few of our assessors, that retired assessors this year, so they're doing a memorial service for them in there. They just had me run back to Baton Rouge and pick up some stuff, so here I come back and send it all to them. And so that's what you do when you know the area and everything. They have you do things and run around and make it work for everybody else.
Well, in the meantime, you're somewhat of a leader in Livingston Parish in drone technology, and I'm sure that's a big discussion here, and some parishes perhaps haven't even started using drones.
Ken, yesterday I did the presentation for drone coverage, and it was pretty cool to realize that most of the offices, they are nowhere even near that. Livingston is on the cutting edge again of this drone technology that we're going to use. I've talked to the sheriff, I've talked to the parish president, that when disasters hit us, it's not just going to be used for me to go out and get properties that I can't get to because of fences or stuff like that, but it's also going to fill in my flyover maps. I don't have to do that every year. I can do it every 4 years now because the drone coverage is going to allow me to GPS that in. But I've talked to the sheriff and the parish president, and I said, your guys need to be taking care of business whenever a disaster goes through here. You need to be helping with sandbags. You need to be helping with traffic and everything like that. My guys are going to be on the first dry spot they can find. They're going to put those drones up in the air, and that way both of those agencies are going to be able to say, okay, here's where the damage is. This is where we got to get people to, because those drones are going to, it's going to take so much more. It's going to cut down on your manpower.
Boy, that's great when you look back to the floods that Livingston has had. Boy, that would have been a godsend in 2016.
Could you imagine if we'd have had that then? I told you the other day that we went to Vermont because Vermont was one of the ones leading edge when they flooded up there. Burlington, Warren, Montpelier, and all that area up in Vermont, they flooded. That's what they used, was this drone technology. And they was able to see who flooded. First off, those people don't need to come off the rolls. The ones that flooded for a month and was back in business, they only need a 1/12. In our case, we just had to say, all right, everybody, you get it. I don't know if you flooded or not, but everybody seemed to have flooded. So we just kind of gave a across-the-board reduction. But when you do that, it spent a lot of sleepless nights of me trying to make sure my districts have enough money, make sure that my constituents are getting the break that they need because of the flood and everything. So it made, if I would have had the drone, it would have helped a whole lot. And I'm so glad we're starting this technology.
You know, I would ask you what's next, but it's got to be AI.
Well, AI is here. You know, I haven't gotten anything yet in my office that's AI, but we're following it because AI, we met with a group the other day that they can come in and you can give them certain coordinates of a building and they can finish out that drawing for you off of AI. And that also cuts down on the number of people that you need out in the field, because we need people that's actually talking to the constituents saying, all right, this is what we're trying to do. What does this do for you? What does it not do for you? We need to get a lot of input, and we've been so busy just working that the input has not been able to be there.
Well, I heard, getting back to this current conference, that most of the assessors were at the LSU Southeastern ball game last night, which is just one example of the amenities, the fun things there are to do around here, including some great restaurants and so forth. So I really wonder about the hospitality that a lot of these people from far-flung places like Caddo Parish or Calcasieu, they'll go back home thinking Hammond's a pretty good place to visit.
Well, you got two things. You had the hotels and everything here, and some of them were full. And so we partnered with Carter Plantation out there. They had two villas, and we took 13 assessors out there. So we've had 13 different assessors stay out there. So they've experienced Carter Plantation. They've experienced Hammond. And so we're back and forth eating in the restaurants. And like you said, the ball game last night, several people went to the ball game. We had some other meetings, so I'm sitting there. And everybody was like, hey, Taylor, can you get us a ticket? Taylor, like, all of a sudden, I'm a Southeastern graduate, and I can just get you tickets to an LSU Southeastern game. So we were able to pull up a few tickets for people.
So I think a lot is going to come down the line from this meeting in Hammond.
Oh, absolutely. We love it here. And I told Jeff, I said, you know, we need to put ourselves in the mix. But this is also going to allow the smaller communities in the state to feel like they can host a convention, because nobody ever thought we could because it didn't have a casino. Well, nobody's going to come. It don't have a casino. It don't have this. Well, they came. And we filled up that room up there, and we've been doing quite well with it.
What else you want to share with us?
I want to share that Jeff Gardner, the president of this, had the insight to get this done. He started working on this over 15 months ago. He said it could be done, even when all of us were like, I don't know if it can be done. We're there with you. We're going to support you. But he wanted to do it, and he deserves a lot of credit for getting this done.